Welcome to another episode of Al's Vintage Toy Trains, and today we're going to talk about turbines. Now, Lionel produced the turbines during the post-war period from 1946 to 1955, so this was a 10-year run, unlike the 21-year run of the Berkshire that I just did recently. So I've got several variations of these, ranging from 1946 up to 1954, 1955. And what I'm showing here in front of the camera is the 682, which was the last variation of the turbine. So let's go ahead and go through the different years and variations that I have. I don't claim to be an expert, but you know, I've got my manuals, Greenberg's, and some others, Doyle's, that helped me discover when these were made. So we'll go ahead and we'll start off with the 1946 that I've got. So Lionel made the 2020 as well as the 671 in 1946 through 1949. So the 2020 was the 027 gauge version and the 671 was the O gauge. So what you'll notice about this 1946 version is there is no protrusion through the top of the shell for the E-unit. So in this case, Lionel used a horizontal E-unit with a spring action, which allowed it to recoil back once power was disconnected to cycle the E-unit. So this is different than most of your post-war engines. It's similar to what the 773 used. You'll notice that the 773 does not have a protruding E-unit lever, just like this doesn't. 1946 was also the introduction of smoke to Lionel's steam engines. And I've got here, and we'll show it to you. This is the smoke bulb that Lionel used for these early steam engines. So this was also used in the 726 as well as the 671. And you'll notice that the bulb has a dimple. And what it would do is when it heated up, that the pellet that you dropped in would melt and create the steam. Wasn't as effective as Lionel had hoped, but it worked for 1946, and then redesigning it, they went to the heat elements in 1947. So this tender is a 2020W tender. It's pretty much the same thing as a 671W tender. Like I said, it was a marketing thing where Lionel marketed the turbine as 027s with 027 sets and the 671 with O gauge sets. So there's the 1946 version of the turbine. Here is a 1947 variation of the 671. It still has the original tender, which was used in the O gauge version from 46 to 47. So this is a 671 tender, whistle tender. And you'll notice that the E unit has the protrusion through the top with the lever on this version. And it's a regular heat coil type smoke unit that we're familiar with most of our post-war engines. All right, so we've got 46 and 47 covered. Like I said, the 46 version all the way through 1949 of the turbines were either number 2020 or 671. All right, Lionel added magnet traction in 1950, so they changed the number of 671 to 681 to show the introduction of magnet traction. Now, I don't have the correct tender with this. I've got a 2671WX tender. It's a six-wheel truck tender, but this is meant to go with a Berkshire, a 1950 or 51 version. I don't have a 50 or 51 version of the Berkshire. I have one that's a little later with the plastic side frame trucks. So I paired it up with this 681 that I think I got this 20 something years ago. And it wasn't the correct tender that came with it, but pretty happy with the six wheel truck tender that is with it right now. All right, so there's the 681. So Lionel made the 681 in 50, 51. They renumbered it back to 671RR in 52, and then in 1953, it was also 681. So there's our 681. And here is the 671RR, or re-release or reissue. And They reverted back to the original 671 number because it lacked the magnet traction. So again, in 1952, the Korean War was going on, and the Alnico, or the aluminum, cobalt, and nickel that was used to make the magnets was in short supply, so Lionel used those only for their diesel engines that year and eliminated it from steam engines. And this came with now four-wheel truck tender. So this is a 2046-50 tender. The 50 or dash 50 just denotes the difference between a Lionel Lines tender and the Pennsylvania tender that came with the turbines. So this is a 2046-50 tender that came with the 671RR. All right. Here we have a 682. This is a fairly new acquisition that I got about 2 months ago. And what's unique about the 682 is Lionel tried to freshen up the turbine a little bit, so they added this little linkage that you see here to the side to add a little more attraction, I think, to the unit. And they also painted the edge of the boiler here in white. So this also came with a 2046-50 tender. Again, if it was just a 2046 tender, it's a four-wheel truck tender, it would have just Lionel Lines on it. The dash 50 denoted the Pennsylvania. And the one that I do not have is the electronic set version of the 671. So the electronic set of the 650 or 671 was made between 1946 and 1949. And for the couplers and running the different cars, there was a different frequency. It used a push-button controller and used radio frequencies to uncouple all the different cars to include the tender. And kind of unique, very expensive set. Not many were made, so I don't have that one as yet, but one day I will. And then one of my favorites here, this is a set that I brought back to life. It was in pretty poor shape when I got it, but this is a 48 version of the 671, and it has the 2671 early W tender with the backup lights. And so it's got the lenses, and it is original. I got it from a person in Maryland back in 2018, and like I said, it was in pretty rough shape. But it was a complete set. It's the 2143 WS set. The insulator, or the transformer car, had broken insulators, which I had to replace. I had to rewire the dump car. The crane car had a broken boom. I had to replace the boom on this one. And then the 2420 caboose, the work caboose, had to be replaced because it had a broken cab, so I replaced it with one in kind, same coloration, because there's some variants of the different colors of gray, and so I was able to complete this set. Took me probably anywhere from 10 to 15 hours to go through this whole set. I remember the turbine engine was missing the rear steps, it was missing some of the side rod screws. You know, I had to go through it and do some full maintenance, just the same thing with the tender, rewiring the pickup trucks, you know, the trucks with the pickups back to the whistle motor, and but well worth it, and one set I really enjoyed bringing back to life. We'll go ahead and run that one now for you, and but I just wanted to give you a little history of the turbines, and let's go ahead and... And run this old set from 1948. I know somebody had mentioned that they really like their turbines, that they run well, and I can definitely attest to that, having probably 8 of these different turbines. And one of my old sayings is that it's really hard to kill a turbine, and this one was in pretty rough shape when I got it. The best piece of this entire set was really the backup light tender. right. This is Al, and thank you very much, and hope you enjoyed this segment on the Lionel post-war turbines. Have a good one.